A vaccine is on the horizon and possibly an end to some of the restrictions governing our lives. But whilst the fight for a medical breakthrough may soon be over, a new war is starting, convincing the public to get inoculated.
I choose not to give my children vaccines, yeah.
Louise Creffield, who's an anti-vaxxer and's campaigned against lockdown, says it's been a busy time, with more members joining her Facebook group, sceptical about any COVID vaccine.
The government have not communicated well. They have changed their mind so many times. They are causing harm to so many people. People are suffering through lockdown this year.
It is difficult to gauge how many people would take a vaccine, but the latest data suggests online scare stories are stoking resistance. The figures show 54% of people would be happy to get vaccinated. But researchers found, after people viewed misinformation online, that figure dropped by 6.4%. It is a rate of uptake which experts say is well below what's needed to achieve herd immunity.
A vaccine is seen as the best way of getting things back to normal, but this latest research is a significant headache for the government, and it's obvious. It doesn't matter how effective it is. If people are reluctant or refuse to take it in large numbers, it simply won't work.
In Manchester, despite the fanfare around the new vaccine advance, people are cautious about whether they'd be first in the queue.
It does concern me that it hasn't gone through the usual length of testing.
I think I'd be a bit reluctant, like, because it's, like, quite new.
Right now, no. I think I'd give it a few months. If I'm honest, yeah, let the first wave of people take it if they wanted to.
Vaccines are historically some of the safest and most successful medicines ever invented. But online, doubts and conspiracy theories persist. Experts are worried.
These anti-groups have gotten quite sophisticated, and when they, you know, they turn things into questions and see doubt and provoke people to question. And that's much harder to just, from a free speech perspective, from a kind of human rights perspective, it's harder to just shut it down.
As a vaccine rollout gets closer, the information war will only intensify. But it's clear the government needs to step up its messaging about safety if it's to convince large sections of the public and save lives. Alex Rossi, Sky News, Brighton.